The second is to use the store connector. Store connector, similar to store builder, allows you to access a store from within widget wrapped in a store connector, but with a finer grained control. Store builder passes the store itself to the builder callback. On the other hand, store connector passes the view model need to rebuild the specific widget to the builder function instead of the entire store. ViewModel is an object with data and methods necessary to build the UI. In store connector, converter callback converts the store to ViewModel before builder callback is executed. The store connector then passes the ViewModel to the builder callback instead of the store. So, store builder passes the entire store to the builder, but store connector creates only the data and methods needed by the widget as a ViewModel and passes it to the builder. I'll get back to you later, but here's a very important point. Even if the widget is wrapped with the store connector, the widget will rebuild whenever the store changes. Then there doesn't seem to be much benefit to using store connector. That's why the store connector can be made to rebuild only when the view model changes for performance optimization, so we can reduce unnecessary rebuilds. To use performance optimization, we need to override the equality operator in hashcode of the view model and set the distinct option of the store connector to true. This performance optimization feature is arguably the biggest reason to use a store connector instead of a store builder. However, there are more cases to consider than you think to get performance optimization. Performance optimization will be dealt with through a separate example. The store connector is very important, so let's go over it again. Store connector builds widgets based on the state of the store. Before the builder callback is executed, the converter callback converts the store into a view model that is tailored to the specific widget. The widget reveals whenever the store changes, but as part of performance optimization, you can only make the widget rebuild when the view model changes. For this to work, you need to override the view model's equality operator and hashcode, and you need to set the distinct option of store connector to true. I will always use the store connector if I need to rebuild the widget when the state changes when creating an app. Let's take a quick look at store connector's constructor. Arguments marked in red are frequently used arguments, and arguments marked in red and bold are the arguments handled in this tutorial. The detailed usage of each argument will be explained while creating the app. Let's start after making store connector exapp and copying the entire contents of the store builder exapp. Store connector requires a view model. ViewModel is an object with data and methods required for widget rebuild. The data required by the MyHomePage widget is the counter value. The counter value is state.counter. And to increment the counter, we need to dispatch an increment action. Also, to decrement the counter, you need to dispatch a decrement action. First, create the ViewModel class and declare final variable counter of integer type. Increment counter of void function type with the integer type argument payload, and decrement counter variable of void function type with the integer type argument payload, and create a constructor. Next, create a static function from store that takes store as an argument and returns a ViewModel instance. The from store function is a convenience function to easily create a ViewModel. The value of counter argument is the value of store.state.counter. And the increment counter function is a function that dispatches increment action using the dispatch function of the store. At this time, the value of payload argument of increment action is the payload argument of increment counter function. And the decrement counter function is a function that dispatches a decrement action using the dispatch function of the store. At this time, the value of payload argument of decrement action is the payload argument of decrement counter function. Now that we have created the view model for our store connector, it's time to apply it to our widget. Next, modify the store builder to be a store connector and add a view model type. Next, call the from store static function of the view model in the converter callback that receives the store as an argument. Replace the store argument of the builder callback with the view model VM. The store.state.counter of the text widget is replaced with the counter value of the view model instance VM. The onPressed callback of the add button calls the increment counter of the view model instance VM, where the value of payload argument is 1. And the onPressed callback of the minus button calls the decrement counter of the view model instance VM, where the value of payload argument is 1. I ran the simulator to test it. App works normally. Those of you familiar with React may have noticed that the role of a store connector is similar to the mapStateToProps and mapDispatchToProps function that React used in the past, and the useSelector and useDispatch hooks used in the latest React.